roaming the world's oceans, a steely predator stalks its prey and strikes without warning. The USS Texas, a submarine unlike any other. Its cruising depth, nearly 1,000 feet beneath the sea. Its weapons, some of the world's deadliest torpedoes, missiles, and special ops commandos. Its mission, deliver a crushing blow wherever it's needed, against enemies at sea and on land. It's time to peel back the steel on this underwater juggernaut, revealing the awesome technology behind its strength.
Solution ready.
And power.
Ship ready.
Shooting to B-24!
Technology that makes this 400-foot submarine invisible.
Lowering number two scope.
And keeps 118 men alive at depths no human can survive. Ready to respond to any threat. Fathom the secrets of the super sub.
Charles, thank you. I'm currently hold 5 ESM contact. Echo 1, classified commercial navigation radar at single strength 3. No threat, bearing 3.
The USS Texas is on a classified mission.
No threat. Bearing 098.
Our intel has shown that there is a super tanker en route to Norfolk carrying possible weapons of mass destruction.
An oil tanker loaded with deadly weapons is sailing toward the coast.
About left 20 degrees, steady course 200.
If the Texas can't stop her, thousands could die. No other sub is better equipped to intervene.
Stand by.
The USS Texas and her sister sub, the USS Virginia, are among the Navy's latest class of attack submarines. And that makes the Texas one of the most sophisticated submarines ever built. She's 377 feet long and weighs over 7,800 tons. But she can maneuver through shallow coastal waters as easily as the deep ocean.
Mission right now is to intercept this supertanker and destroy it using ATCAP torpedoes.
It looks like we're in a good position to achieve a firing position.
In the blink of an eye, she sends the tanker to a watery grave. This time, it's only a training exercise.
Stand down for battle stations.
But the crew of the Texas knows next time could be the real thing. They're sailing on the latest generation of super sub. The Texas represents a radical leap in sub design. It's among the deepest and longest running nuclear attack submarines ever built. To plumb the secrets of the super sub, we'll build it from scratch, watch it become a weapon, and reveal how a 7,800-ton shark becomes invisible and can spot a potential enemy 1,000 miles away. We'll see how other super subs are challenging its supremacy in stealth and firepower. And see what happens when disaster strikes. The secrets of the super sub begin long before its first dive. This is the birthplace of the American submarine fleet for over a century. The USS Texas is the product of two shipyards, Electric Boat and Northrop Grumman. And she's one of the first American warships designed entirely on a computer.
John, let's take a close-up view of the auxiliary machinery room module.
Engineers walk virtual crewmen through the engine room to perfect its layout, a tight fit that has to accommodate crew, engines, generators, and propulsion machinery. Flash detection software tests the smallest details like the opening and closing of weapon 2 hatches. It can reveal any collision between hatch and clasp before construction begins. Last step, the design software sends the approved blueprints directly to the machines that cut the steel, shape components, and bend pipes. Now it's time to build the Texas, and that process is just as revolutionary. Groton submakers used to build their boats from the inside out, working in the cramped space of the hull. Engineers say that's like building a Swiss watch through the stem. Now they'll build the Texas the opposite way, from the outside in. They'll construct separate modules of everything a submarine needs. The engine room, the torpedo room, and its nerve center, the command and control room. Each component slides neatly into the hull. But an ingenious design doesn't guarantee the Texas will survive in the real world. A world of airless, dark depths, crushing water pressures, and hostile weapons. Her designers test her toughness on their computers with a devastating virtual assault from an enemy mine or torpedo.
What we're going to see here is a mathematical simulation of an underwater explosion that's the result of a combat action.
Unlike a land explosion, a torpedo or mine doesn't shatter its target with a single blow. An underwater blast generates a series of shock waves so powerful that it could make a submarine tear itself apart. When the computer hits the virtual Texas, red spots indicate she's feeling the pain. Yet her designers know that her enemies will never stop building even deadlier weapons to destroy her. After 5 years on the factory floor, 1 million parts, 1,000 miles of fiber optics and cables, 14 million hours of labor, and over $2 billion. The USS Texas is finally ready for action. Workers roll her onto a giant floating dry dock. As it carefully delivers her to the sea, her home, and her deadliest enemy. For no human adversary threatens submarines like the deep ocean. The Texas and its sister subs carry 118 men, but the super sub's most important mission is to take those men where they cannot possibly survive, hundreds of feet underwater, and keep them safe for months at crushing depths. More than anything else, she must never fail to give her crew the most basic of all human needs, air. The first submariners knew they were running out of oxygen when they started getting sick.
Crews were sometimes actually poisoned by a combination of either the diesel fumes or the battery fumes.
Earlier subs tried keeping their crews alive with tanks of pressurized gas, snorkel tubes to draw clean air from the surface, and even chemicals that released oxygen. But the Texas has a revolutionary oxygen generator. Even when she's running hundreds of feet deep, her crew breathes better air than what you're breathing right now. Onboard sensors continuously monitor the air supply, scrubbing it with filters that trap contaminants, remove carbon dioxide, and suck out excess moisture. And while she's submerged, the Texas replenishes its air from an unexpected source, the ocean around her. It can actually turn seawater into clean air by separating its basic chemical components, hydrogen and oxygen. In 1 hour, the Texas can extract nearly 225 cubic feet of oxygen, more than twice what her crew needs to survive. Yet submariners never truly breathe easy. The deeper they dive, the greater the danger. Just how deep the USS Texas can dive is classified. The Navy will only admit to 800 feet, as deep as the Eiffel Tower is high.
On deck, all conditions, normal to dive 155 feet.
Very well, Bob.
At that depth, the water pressure would instantly kill a human, with more than 360 pounds per square inch of crushing force. It's like parking a truck on your chest. Aboard the Texas, all that stands between life and death is 3 inches of metal. But not just any metal. High-pressure structural steel called HY-100, the strongest submarine hull ever built. But the Texas's job is not just to survive, it's to fight and win. The Super Sub boasts one of the deadliest arsenals on Earth. But another nation is developing a torpedo so fast that the USS Texas may not detect it before it strikes. Turning a submarine into a weapon requires two technological feats, stealth and firepower. The U.S. Navy's Virginia-class subs, the USS Texas and Virginia, are among the most powerful underwater weapons ever built.
Last man down, head secure.
When these predators go into action, they dive out of sight like every other submarine.
Decks awash.
40 feet.
Scopes awash.
But the key to destroying an enemy is to see and hear it before it hears you. And the Super Sub has some of the most powerful underwater eyes and ears ever made.
Corner, sonar, I have news contact bearing 307, designate 063 in ATF Alpha 3.
Captain, gain new submerged contact, Sierra 63 bearing 307 in ATF.
Very well.
Attention control, sonar gain new contact, Sierra 63. I intend to engage this contact with one ADCAP torpedo. Send them a firing solution.
Earlier subs had to scan the surface through a periscope. They couldn't see more than a few miles away. But the Super Sub sees the world through space-age cameras that can peer tens of miles away.
All stations coordinator, Sierra 63 is contact bearing 307 is the contact of interest, track Sierra 63.
These cameras send crisp images to the control room.
We have a contact that's about 9 miles away. You can see how close we can make them appear when we magnify the scope.
An infrared laser rangefinder tells the crew the exact distance to the target, an enemy ship. The Texas has locked onto its target. Now it's time to destroy it. The torpedo is still the submarine's signature weapon, famous from World War II, when German subs hunted Allied warships in squadrons called wolfpacks. But a Super Sub is a wolf pack of one. It can carry 38 torpedoes, three times as many torpedoes as the Type 7 German U-boat did. In its bow, four 21-inch torpedo tubes can launch both torpedoes and missiles.
Captain, I have a firing solution, sir.
Very well.
Firing point procedures, Sierra 63, tube 4.
Historically, crews had to move and load 2-ton torpedoes by hand. A slow, dangerous process.
Caution, guide sled must be lying, guide sled to bring it to.
Today, it's fully automated. Torpedo men can load and reload tubes in 1/3 of the time.
Solution ready.
Ship ready.
Tube 4.
Shooting, torpedo tube 4.
Pressurized water propels the torpedo from the sub toward its target. A piston engine with two propellers maximizes the torpedo's power.
Sonar holds ownership unit running normally.
But the torpedo isn't flying blind. It trails a wire plugged into the weapon systems aboard the sub, using data to navigate. The bomb accelerates to 32 knots, over 35 miles an hour, with a range of 8 miles. And as it nears its target, the wire is cut, and its sonar takes over navigation. This one torpedo has the explosive power of 1,200 pounds of TNT.
Weapon is acquisition.
If the torpedo misses its target, it can circle back around and re-attack.
Exploder arms.
Detonating below the ship.
Loud explosion on the bearing of Sierra 6-3.
But there's one flaw in the Super Sub's torpedoes. Enemy sonar can hear them coming, giving their targets a chance to avoid them before they strike. But half a world away, engineers are building a new kind of torpedo, one that no one can detect. One that can kill a Super Sub. Proving ground of the Barracuda, the torpedo of tomorrow. The Barracuda torpedo replaces the piston engine with a rocket engine. It can power the Barracuda through water at 360 kilometers per hour, nearly four times faster than the Super Sub's torpedoes. The Barracuda is so fast, it actually creates a pocket of air underwater. The only thing touching the water is the nose cone that steers it. It's a phenomenon known as supercavitation. Moving through air produces less friction than moving through water. And less friction means greater speed.
And it goes so fast that no target can possibly get out of the way in time, and it's just going to hit.
Traveling faster than the speed of sound, the Barracuda actually outruns its own sound waves. Even a Super Sub sonar may not hear the Barracuda until it strikes. As torpedoes like the Barracuda become more advanced, the Super Sub's only defense is to improve its stealth. Running silent has long been the submariner's greatest advantage, a technological game of cat and mouse that has been escalating since World War II. Naval engineers are developing top secret designs that give the USS Texas the ultimate advantage. Invisibility. Submarine was born to be stealthy. But to the latest generation of super subs, like the USS Texas, stealth means more than hiding underwater. It means becoming what submariners call a hole in the water. Speed in utter silence. A critical innovation, because when a sub loses the element of surprise, the results can be devastating. 1942, the German Navy uses the stealth of their Unterseeboot, the U-boat, to reign supreme. Roaming in wolf packs, striking almost invisibly, the U-boat sinks supply ships by the thousands. But the U-boats have an Achilles heel. They must surface at night to recharge their batteries. The Allies arm warships and planes with radar to locate the U-boats. It turns the once feared hunters into the prey.
Once they were located, they were, in a way, defeated already.
The U-boats don't stand a chance on the surface. They dive and make a run for it. But their fate is sealed by sonar. A technology whose name means sound, navigation, and ranging. A transmitter sends an electrical impulse from the surface ship, which releases a sound wave into the water. The classic ping from submarine movies. Traveling at 4,800 feet per second, the sound waves bounce back from solid objects, revealing a hidden U-boat. Sonar exacts a heavy toll on the mighty U-boats. For a super sub to remain undetected by modern sonar, it must become a hole in the water, quieter than the surrounding sea. And far from the oceans, a secret laboratory is perfecting stealth, working to make the Texas invisible. Lake Pendere in Idaho. Hundreds of miles from the prying eyes and ears of potential adversaries. Cameras have never before had permission to film the cutthroat, the largest unmanned submarine in the world. Its job, teach engineers to make the Texas even quieter. This 1/3 scale model of the USS Texas is a perfect likeness, right down to the top secret propulsor, specially designed to increase thrust, and most importantly, minimize noise. Inside, a massive array of batteries power the sub's brain, a bank of computers that pilot the model, following a programmed course. At over 1,000 feet deep, this cold water lake is one of the quietest testing grounds in the world, perfect for evaluating classified designs, like stealth battleships, invisible to radar. Every waterborne vehicle has a unique acoustic signature. The sound made by water moving over its hull.
Motors answering 70 RPM.
Roger that. Vehicle's underway.
If the Virginia-class subs have an acoustic weakness, these men are among the few on Earth who know what it is.
That's affirmative. Proceed to the sub.
Underwater microphones listen in as the sub dives, allowing the Navy to hear what an enemy would hear.
The hydrophones are so sensitive, we can detect snow falling on the water right now.
Here, fine-tuning the design of this sub to maximize stealth is an obsession.
We've made very, very minute, very, very detailed changes, especially in the propulsor, that have made significant improvements in the acoustic performance of the propeller.
Making a hole in the water means more than just building a mechanically and hydrodynamically quiet submarine. It means absorbing sound. Sources from outside the Navy say most modern subs are coated with a material called anechoic, or anti-echo. When a sonar ping strikes the sub, this classified rubber-like material actually absorbs the sound without reflecting it back to the source. Stealth is important to the super sub's survival, but if the USS Texas and her sister, the Virginia, want to survive in this open ocean battlefield, they must see and hear the world around them to navigate, attack, or defend themselves against enemies. The super sub literally paints a picture of her environment with sound.
It's our only way to know what's in front of us, what's to the left, what's to the right, and where we have to go to avoid running into other ships in the sea. Obviously, we don't have windows, so what's emerged, this is truth.
The super sub can hear better than any sub man has ever put into the water. It has 10 sonar arrays, mounted in the sail, on the sides, in the bow, and one towed behind her, all working with sound to produce a view of the underwater landscape like never before. Each line on the screen represents a contact, anything in or on the water that makes noise, from a whale to a cruise ship to a fishing boat.
This is a merchant ship. It sounds like just a coastal merchant, probably not anything real large. And what you're hearing when we're listening to this is the screw turning in the water and air bubbles forming and then collapsing on the tips and the face of the blades, as well as just the sound of it turning and propelling the ship through the water.
The final piece of technology that allows the super sub to find its enemy lies hidden behind a composite material dome, the spherical bow array. Mounted with hundreds of hydrophones, it allows sonar operators to hear ships in the water up to 1,000 miles away.
Con sonar, gain new wad detection bearing 258, detonate Sierra 4.
Sonar signals are processed by computers with more number-crunching power than nearly every U.S. sub in history combined. Yet there are some threats that the Texas may simply not be able to hear until it's too late. A technological ghost from World War II has returned to haunt the oceans. The waning days of the war. Using radar, the Allies devastate the German submarine fleet. The Germans realize the U-boat's fatal flaw. Its mechanical engines periodically need air to recharge their batteries. Every time a U-boat surfaces, it's dangerously exposed. A brilliant German engineer, Helmut Walter, devises a way to keep U-boats underwater longer. It's called Air Independent Propulsion, or AIP. The Type 21 U-boat is born.
He had ideas which were revolutionary in a way. So he invented this streamlined submarine, capable of doing high speeds, was far ahead of his time.
The Type 21 accomplishes unprecedented stealth. The secret, a massive bank of batteries that enable the sub to remain submerged longer and still reach speeds of 16 knots, faster than the U.S. convoys on the surface. But the war ends before Germany can unleash air independent propulsion and the world's first super sub. 50 years later, the concept of AIP resurfaces, both in Germany and Sweden. The Swedish Navy's Gotland measures merely 200 feet, half the size of the Texas. Intended for coastal defense, the Gotland values stealth over firepower. Her secret? The incredibly quiet Cockham Stirling engine. It uses a mix of diesel fuel and liquid oxygen to power a generator, which in turn powers the ship's ultra-quiet electric motor. Encased in soundproofing, the Gotland's engine is so quiet, so hard to detect, that the U.S. Navy has rented her from Sweden for use in war games.
One of the worst things that Texas could encounter is one of the new generation AIP submarines laying in wait that knows the territory, knows where the nooks and crannies around the continental shelf are, and understands the local acoustics.
If Sweden's Gotland-class sub is quiet, this German sub is almost silent. The 212 Alpha. It cannot outrun or outgun a steel shark like the Texas, but it's powered by a chemical reaction so quiet that builders say it can disappear at will. The 212 Alpha. Born in the same shipyards that would have built Walter's revolutionary AIP U-boat.
Even design, we are designing the shaping of the submarine.
Today's German Navy isn't building hunter killers, but sentries and spies to patrol shallow waters. The 212 Alpha's stealth begins on the outside. Its hull design slips quietly through the water, reflecting little sound.
And interestingly, the welding is done on the spot.
Computers cut every piece of the sub, and before workers weld hull sections together, they preheat them to give them maximum strength. A process so incredibly precise, it measures errors in millimeters. When it's finished, the 212 Alpha's even smaller than the Gotland and doesn't need a nuclear power plant or the Gotland's mechanical engine.
We do not need any piston engine generators, clutches, or something like that. The old technology is gone. We have the new technology with fuel cells.
To power this generation of submarines, the German Navy uses fuel cells. Often cited as the ultimate source of cheap energy for homes and cars. This is what the 212 Alpha sounds like when using its conventional diesel engine. When it wants to slip silently below the waves, it switches on a bank of fuel cells. And with a flick of a switch, the 212 Alpha disappears.
Yes, the boat is switched to silent mode now, and we are switching on the fuel cell plant. And the fuel cell plant powers the propulsion engine. This electrical engine runs with more than 1,000 horsepower now, and you don't hear anything. We are a hole in the water now.
The German Navy won't reveal just how long and how fast the 212 Alpha can run underwater on its fuel cells. They say only that it can stay submerged and hidden for weeks on end.
It's fine to have a stealthy submarine like a nuclear, but this is more. This is super stealth.
Impressive as it is, super stealth alone doesn't make a super sub. Firepower. Endurance. Unlimited reach. All put the Texas in a class by itself. But every submariner knows, the ocean is more powerful than any sub ever built. One breach can flood an entire ship in minutes. Even a minor mechanical failure or human error can turn the super sub into an incinerator. If catastrophe strikes, survival will depend on the fast action of her crew and some ingenious devices that are revolutionizing underwater rescues. Nothing man can construct, not even the most advanced submarine in the world, the super sub, is impervious to the crushing forces of the deep, weapons of war, or human error. Before a crew dares take a submarine to sea, they must learn how to operate it flawlessly, and they must know how to keep her from killing them when disaster strikes. A collision against an undersea mountain 600 feet below the surface breaches the sub's hull.
Surface.
And sends 12,000 gallons per minute of bone-chilling water into the engine room. The situation instantly goes from bad to worse.
Collision, port side.
Unrelenting pressure causes intake pipes and valves to burst. These men have only seconds to manage the crisis and save the sub. One false move may kill them.
Resume training.
It's a scenario that plays out daily in a Navy wet trainer.
Caution them to adjust, split, and roll.
The submariners run the exercise again and again. This time, they manage to stop the breach. Barely. This is where submariners learn everything they'll see, hear, and feel.
Quartermaster sounding.
When operating a super sub during a mission or a crisis.
Scope is clear.
Before they're handed the keys to a $2.5 billion submarine, they'll learn to dive and drive their new sub in a V-Scott. Virginia class ship control operator trainer.
Secondary Ansel has two thirds captain.
Jam dive.
Jam dive.
This simulator is about as close to being out to sea without being out to sea that we're ever going to get.
Dive!
And with that comes the adrenaline of being underway.
The pilot's job is mission critical, especially when disaster strikes.
Flooding in the engine room. Let me see flow.
Maintain a 20 degree up angle.
Maintain a 20 degree up angle, pilot eye.
4.5 degrees are blowing.
Knowing how to surface the super sub in seconds may be the difference between life and death. January 8, 2005. The USS San Francisco is cruising Pacific waters south of Guam. Its navigational charts are incomplete, and the captain and his crew unaware. Without warning, this 7,000-ton submarine crashes headfirst into an undersea mountain. 98 of its 137 sailors are injured, and one fatally. But the San Francisco does not die.
And what is amazing is that that crew, bloodied, beaten up, hurting, immediately were able to go and become their own lifesavers, sustaining their efforts to go ahead and deal with damage, flooding, systems that had gone bad, and get themselves to the surface.
When the sub finally limps into dry dock in Guam, the extent of her damage is stunning. Her sonar dome crushed, 3 ballast tanks damaged, and all 4 torpedo tubes deformed and inoperable. But like the Texas, this sub can survive a staggering blow from the outside. Yet every submariner knows that a much deadlier enemy strikes from within.
Code red machine room, code red from the forward trim pump, priming pump.
Fire.
This is one of the worst casualties that we could possibly experience. The entire crew, the entire submarine is at stake.
Smoke can cut visibility to zero. It's like being trapped in a burning building.
It starts wearing you down. Over time, you start getting tired, exhausted.
Temperatures can quickly soar into the hundreds of degrees, unchecked, up to 2,000 degrees.
Start firing pretty heavy, getting dehydrated, and that's the key. You don't want to get dehydrated.
Submarines aren't just watertight. They're airtight, a closed container. A fire on a sub can literally suck the air from the men's lungs.
We don't have the luxury of calling for help and having assistance. If there's a fire, we have to put it out. It's a do-or-die situation.
Training in real-time simulators like this is a subcrew's best defense against an onboard catastrophe like fire. But no simulated training can defend them against a silent predator that lurks in dark waters, lying in wait indefinitely. One of a sub's deadliest enemies, the mine.
Since the end of the Vietnam War, mines have caused more damage to U.S. warships than all the other kinds of weapons combined that have been used against us.
Finding mines is dull, dangerous work. In Cambridge, Massachusetts, the U.S. Navy is perfecting a secret weapon, the UUV, or Unmanned Undersea Vehicles. Advanced scouts that map minefields. The Bluefin 21 looks like a torpedo because it's designed to be shot from a torpedo tube. But this machine isn't designed to kill. Its mission is to save lives by identifying mines before they explode. The trade-off for the Navy: sacrifice a $500,000 UUV to save a multi-billion-dollar sub and its crew.
Texas's ability to launch unmanned underwater vehicles, or UUVs, that can go out and conduct mine hunting and mine surveillance is a critical, critical capability.
Started this green flag and transited this green dot here.
Tom Barron of the Naval Undersea Warfare Center wants to test the mine mapping capabilities of the UUV. To see how the Bluefin works, he gives it the task of finding a shipwreck.
What's the resolution of the...
We go down, this sonar goes down to 10 centimeters resolution.
Okay.
So we should get a pretty good picture of whatever's laying on the seafloor.
The UUV pilots itself with artificial intelligence. It will run along parallel paths, 3/4 mile long and 500 feet wide, avoiding unexpected obstacles while taking pictures and staying on course. The Bluefin can map 8 square miles of ocean in one mission, cruising for up to 18 hours on battery power. But recovering the UUV is much harder than launching it.
As you know, we launched it out of the torpedo tube like a regular torpedo. The hard part is getting it back onto the boat.
Engineers at Electric Boat are already planning to retrofit the Texas with an ingenious arm that will reach out to grab the UUV and pull it back into the sub after completing its mission. Back at the demonstration, the Bluefin crew retrieves their UUV and downloads the data from its hardware, just as the crew of the Texas will. Tom and the Bluefin team scan the images to see if the UUV found the shipwreck.
Oh, wait, it's here. There it is. There it is. Great. Awesome.
The UUV has proven itself, forcing the murky water to give up its secrets with stunning resolution.
You can easily make out man-made structures like mines with this.
But if the UUV fails on a real mission, mines can devastate a sub. And when a submarine's in trouble, deep underwater, the crew's only hope for survival is another kind of super sub, built to pull sailors from the jaws of death. The DSRV, Deep Submergence Rescue Vehicle. The Navy calls it the Mystic. Kept on call 24/7. The Mystic can fly anywhere in the world, loaded on board a plane, or piggybacked on a specially configured attack submarine.
All it takes is a phone call. We should be able to be on a plane within 4 hours.
Within 24 hours, the Mystic's on site. Its sonar listens for the crippled sub's distress signal and zeroes in on its location.
It's right over the target.
Every second is precious to a crew whose air supply is fading. The pilot establishes radio communications with the down sub's crew.
Kelly, this is Mystic.
This drill takes place in a tank that's merely 30 feet deep, but the Mystic's fiberglass hull hides three interconnected spheres that can withstand the pressure of a 5,000-foot dive, nearly 1 mile deep. Once the pilot has a visual on the sub's escape hatch, he carefully guides the Mystic into place and makes a watertight seal. In a real-life scenario, 24 men at a time would scramble through the hatch to safety and live to fight another day. Generations of submariners went to sea risking hidden undersea dangers, onboard fires, and naval mines. The crew of the USS Texas faces those traditional perils with state-of-the-art equipment and the most advanced training in the history of the Silent Service. But the Texas and her crew must also combat a new kind of enemy that attacks from multiple fronts, conceals its position, and runs covert operations on land and sea. The worldwide threat of terrorism. And in the war against terror, the super sub fully reveals her awesome power to search and destroy. October 12, 2000. The American destroyer USS Cole refuels in the port of Yemen. A small boat approaches and detonates, punching a 40 by 60 foot hole in the ship, killing 17 sailors. The Cole attack is a chilling reminder that in the new century, there's a new kind of global warfare. Enemies hiding in secret safe houses, plotting terror. Incapable of striking anywhere, anytime. But terrorists like the Cole bombers now face a formidable opponent. The Super Sub. It's the perfect linchpin in any future attack on terrorists. Before they can strike.
RadioCon, log off the satellite.
Submarines used to operate as lone wolves, going months without communicating with the fleet for fear of revealing their position. But today, the super sub communicates with headquarters by releasing a small buoy that floats to the surface on a 2,000-foot cable. The buoy will link the super sub to a communications network called ForceNet. The network will allow all Navy assets on Earth to coordinate an attack.
Radio Con, I'm...
Net ready to bring the message to the Con.
Yes, sir. Radio Con, route the message to the Con.
ForceNet downloads a detailed picture of a terrorist base. The orders from Navy Command. Cruise in close to the coastline and land a SEAL team to confirm the enemy is there. This is the type of mission the Super Sub was born to execute. The Super Sub carries a 9-man SEAL team, the Navy's elite sea, air, and land force.
Officer Deck, prepare to hover, prepare to conduct lockout trunk operations.
A special lock-in lockout chamber allows the SEALs to exit the sub underwater in the dark of night. Unseen and unheard.
Putting people ashore from a submarine is a difficult task because the other side is going to be looking for that submarine. They may have coastal radar, they may have aircraft, they may even have seafloor acoustic detection systems. The closer you bring the submarine in to 5 or 10 miles, the greater the chance of detection, and the greater the chance the submarine's going to run aground on an uncharted sandbar, a coral reef, or something else.
But delivering Navy SEALs to an enemy's doorstep in dangerously shallow water is just what this submarine does best. The SEAL team floats to the surface and heads for shore on inflatables. They work their way inland until they find the enemy. Surrounding his base and confirming its location. The hunt is over. Now, it's time for the kill. The SEAL team relays the information back to the sub.
Air contacts.
Con ASM, our whole threat emitters is what you can see that.
Yes, I'm Con I.
It then sends the updated target information to ForceNet. Far out at sea, a warship sends a Tomahawk missile screaming toward the target. Once the missile's launched, the SEALs keep the terrorists pinned down until the Tomahawk arrives. The missile screams toward the target at 550 miles per hour. GPS satellites download the coordinates to the missile, and the Tomahawk locks in on the exact location of the target. If the target moves, the SEALs relay his new position to their sub. The sub relays it to ForceNet, and the warship re-aims the Tomahawk in mid-flight, ensuring a perfect strike.
Sun Radio, SEAL Team Alpha reports mission complete, en route to our location.
Radio Con I.
One machine has made it possible, the Navy's newest breed of super sub, the Virginia class. Unprecedented endurance and stealth, formidable firepower, and new capabilities to unleash a precision attack on any enemy, anywhere on Earth. But the Super Sub has one final secret. The Navy has made her future-proof thanks to an ingenious design. Years from now, when new technology or weapon systems come online, they can slice her in half, open her up, and update her design. The ultimate in plug-and-play. The USS Texas will have to make room for innovation. But unlike its predecessors, this super sub is built for the future.